Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today I wanted to share how I set up Macs. This is pretty much like when I install my Macs, what are the first settings that I, you know, kind of set up, you know? So I don't know, maybe it will give you some nice ideas, maybe you'll learn something. This is similar to Known Unknown Depths, but it's like setting up Max edition kind of thing. So I generally kind of listed down about 10 things that I do with my fresh Max. So let's just start. So customize, I got a couple of features that I set here. So in the customize, when you install Corona as a rendering engine, a lot of you know this, you can choose the color selector. It's default color picker. You could choose the Corona improved one. And then your color picker is pretty much going to look like this instead of the native Max color picker. Next thing that I do is, again, in the preferences, right under the color picker, you have scroll bar size. So take a look at this. If I create a teapot converted to editable poly, one thing that annoyed me over the years is how tiny the scroll bar here on the right is. You know, I know I can kind of grab on the empty area, but, you know, just have this habit of actually aiming for the scroll bar. And I was actually very happy when I discovered that you can actually change the size of that. So if you set the scroll bar size to large and hit OK, look at this. You've got a fat scroll bar now. I like this. It's kind of visually handy. Another thing that I also set up is, I covered this in earlier videos. So reference coordinate system, I set that to constant. So what does that mean? I'm gonna just turn it off now just to show you. So let's say in your, so on my teapot, on my move tool, I got view mode here. Then if I go to the rotate here, I'm, for example, need to use local, you know, then I'm going to go to scale, and on the scale, I'm going to need to use, I don't know, gimbal, right? Whenever I would be setting, you know, a specific reference coordinate system like local, I would always be, you know, needing that local for all the others, you know, for move, rotate, etc. And what always annoyed me is, like, I would go to rotate, it would have the local, but then I would go to move and it would be view, you know, I would go to scale, it would be gimbal. So if you go to your preferences and click here on the constant, and now if I set, you know, my scale to be local, look, even the rotate, move, all of them are local. So it just, you know, it kind of links, everything just gets links. If you go to screen, it's just to see screen. So yeah, I kind of always use that feature. One thing that I always set up whenever I'm setting up my Macs is I always install the Pulse Scene Manager. That thing is an ultimate plugin to have. With Scene Manager, you can like control your entire scenes. Like you can set up multiple cameras in each camera to have like its own world of information within. Like you can have, you know, one camera seeing one object, you know, here, but the other camera sees that same object there. The objects are not cloned. They can also change materials per camera. It's stupid what this thing can do. If you haven't checked Scene Manager, just go to pulse.io and check what's up. They also have their Project Dream, which is like an AI tool where you can enhance your images, add details. Like, look at this. The face was like this. Boom, look at him now. He looks real and he's, you know, more natural. But what I personally use this thing the most is in like an idea generator. So look at this, you prepare a scene like this and it just gives you an idea on how the scene might look like. This is a turbo handy tool to try, so definitely check this one out. Okay, let's continue with Mac stuff. Next thing that I like to use is, if we go to preferences again, auto window crossing by direction. This is the one that I have set left to right. So what does that do? Window and crossing thing is pretty much this. You see like window and crossing. So what does that do? So when this option is turned on, when you select like a selection of objects like this, it's only gonna select what is only in the selection. You see like this. Then if you turn it off, you know, it will generally select whatever the selection is touching plus what's on the inside. But what does this feature do? When you turn this on, what it basically does, if you start selecting from left to right, it's gonna select whatever is there. But if you start selecting from right to left, it's gonna select whatever is, you know, completely in the selection. Meaning that when you do the left to right, it's gonna select everything, but right to left, it's gonna use it like you have that window crossing option enabled. Another thing that I also always like to do is I like to increase my precision. So precision 2 pretty much gives you this. Something point, you know, 0.8. But if you set precision to, let's say, 5, I think 5 is too much. It kind of just got used to it. You're pretty much getting this. You see, like 3.20377. It's just a habit of mine to have that. See if maybe you want three. So one other thing that I also like to have is wrap cursor near spinner. So you see, like, whenever you're kind of increasing the size of this, you see how my mouse is going all the way to the top from the, you know, bottom to the top of the screen. Well, if you enable wrap cursor near spinner, your mouse won't fly off. You see, it will just be here. It will just, you know, move a couple of centimeters. So that's kind of a handy feature. Now, in the preference settings, if I go to files, there is also one cool thing, prepend scene name. So prepend scene name can generally be very dangerous but also super useful. So what does that do? So for example, I have 10 of my Autobacks saved at all time, right? Whatever I'm working on, it's going to save 10 Autobacks. But when you click on the prepend scene name, it's going to save 10 Autobacks per max file. So if you're, for example, working on a max project that's called house, and then you're working on a max project that's called interior, he's gonna save two separate sets of 10, you know, Autoback files for each project. Now, if you are changing, like if you have a lot of projects kind of rotating and going on, you can have thousands of Autoback files. So sometimes that can be an overkill. But I found it actually very, very useful because I used to find it, you know, like corrupt max projects. And then, you know, the projects were 3 months old or something. And then I would go to my Autoback and I would have an Autoback from that old project still. So yeah, that kind of saved my ass a lot of times. Now, this other thing is actually in Material Editor. So whenever I need to use multi-sub object, I always use like 2 or 3 slots of multi-subs. When you create a multi-sub, it's always gonna create like 10 slots, you know, like 10 multi-sub slots. So what I did, go to options, preferences, and you can set number of sub materials, and you can change that from 10, I have it on 2. So what does that mean? That whenever I create a multi-sub object, it's always gonna be created with just 2 slots instead of 10. You know, I always hated, you know, when you have 10 of them and then you use just 2 and then the others are hanging, then you have to remove them. Yeah. And the last thing that I do, this is an absolute must in setting up my Macs. It's actually a tip that I learned from Changsu. So it's this 3ds Max tip, 3ds Max ini settings for file load save speed up. So what is this thing all about? You know that moment when you load in a Max file that you got and it has some textures and you load it in, and of course Max cannot find the textures because, you know, somebody sent you an object, you downloaded it from 3D Sky or whatever, and the Max gives you an option to set like a search path, like a search directory for those textures, right? So what I would do in the very, very core beginning of my career, I would pretty much set these search directories everywhere, and I would have hundreds of search directories, and opening every scene would be a freaking pain in the ass. Because what is happening under the hood? So let's say that, you know, you have, I don't know, 20, 30, 50 of these search directories kind of collected over time, right? If I send you the object that has some textures in it, Max won't find the textures because he doesn't know where the textures are, but he will try to search throughout all these 50 directories to see if they are there. Therefore, it will take hell of a long time just, you know, to kind of process it all and then to open the scene. And not only that, this code will generally, you know, like when you import a file into Max and it gives you that pop-up that says, you know, this texture is missing, this texture is missing, this texture is missing, this disables that also. So what is happening? You pretty much just say to your Max, just open the file, I don't give a damn what is missing. And it's gonna do that. What, like, I remember the first time when I tested it, I took a file from 3D Sky. Like, before that, it would open for like, I don't know, 15, 20 seconds. After this, it opened in like 3 seconds, right? I know that the files are missing. I know that I need to assign them. But what Max is doing at that point, he's actually searching through all those directories, folders that you set up over time, trying to find those files. He's pretty much wasting your time. So setting this up was a complete game changer for my workflow. It saved me tons of times, and I hope it will save yours. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye.